And then, whenever you want.
Hello, we are the truck drivers. My name is Anna, she is Irene. We are going to make a pechakucha presentation which consists on 20 slides with 20 seconds for everyone. We hope you learn a lot and join with us. So please pay attention and let's start.
Our project is named Experiencia Matemáticas sin Tiza. It was carried out by Agatine Zarate, Manuela Virto, and Juan Carlos Guerra, three teachers of secondary education at the ESA de Oriaga in Vizcaya.
We have contacted with them through Twitter, blog, and mail. Also, we have to create a Twitter account too. They have helped us a lot, and they were very proud because of the interest in their project.
We are going to analyze the project from two points of view. On the one hand, we will analyze the different curriculum elements. And on the other hand, we will analyze the relationship between feedback perspective and the activities of this project.
One of the curriculum elements is people and institutions. Our school project is named Tiza de Oriaga, and it is placed in Vizcaya. It is a comprehensive school. It has a lot of resources, so we could say that this is a high quality school.
The project is aimed at the student of 3 and 4 ESO and bachillerato, especially for first year. They don't have a student with disabilities at this level. And a student with a special needs, for example, recent immigrants, are not much support outside the class.
In the ESO classes, there are 20 students, and on bachillerato, there are 25 approximately. The reaction of the students are diverse. Some of them react very well to the project, but some of them refuse the work because it is like an extra work.
The key objective is that the students get involved in their own learning. Some of the assessments are individual and other works are collaborative. And in addition, the full development of student autonomy is tried to research and familiarity with new technologies as well.
The different works that the students make involves 2 points of the final global mark, but they are evaluated with a written exam because the objective is that they acquire the different curriculum contents.
All the process is assessed when they evaluate the work of a student. If they use the tools correctly, the quality of the presentation, the easy way to use IDCs, that means digital competence is evaluated as a process of math learning.
They use a lot of resources, technical resources like PCs, digital boards, wikis, and 2.0 applications, and LMs like webs, Google Docs, blogs.
The BT tool is used to build timeline to work history of mathematics. It a student adds an element with a short text video found in the internet and a link to a document in Google Docs.
Another activity is classroom blog. It is used by students like a digital notebook. Here, the students publish their works, their activities, their problems to share them with their classmates and teachers.
They has created a website where teachers post the topic explicated in class. In this case, we can see our teacher explain the history of number complexes.
Number complexes, okay.
Yes, and has proposed an activity related to the topic.
PA1, a collaborative blog, is a blog to publish some exercises or information found on the internet about the number P day that is celebrated worldwide in the 14th of March. here there is no information, but it is in Euskera.
They have created a wiki where the materials they create are collected. Links, model of exams, tests, problem solving.
We could say that the realization of timelines in collaborative blogs and websites could be involved with technological content knowledge, because it tries to work the different curriculum elements with using technology to learn, expand, and interact the curriculum content.
About the creation of the wiki blog, Wikia blog, we can say that it corresponds with the content technological knowledge too, according to the explanation given above.
Teachers had a lot of difficulties, like poor connectivity on the internet, lack of materials, lack of hours to develop the project, and so on. The only difficulty that we have been the language, because the project and the web page will be in Euskera.
So that's all. This has been our pechakucha presentation about the project Experiencia Matemáticas in Tiza. We would like to thank the great collaboration of the teacher involved in the project, and we hope you like and you have learned.